All right, hello, welcome to another episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. Today we will be playing against Lazio away from home. We're going to be travelling to Italy, so it's going to be a fun one. It's going to be a difficult one by all imagination, because we've actually got some tired players, but we've also changed up the formation. I don't know how that will impact us against Lazio. What we are going to do, though, is I'm going to show you what happened in the last game. I'm going to show you what happened over March and then show you what we've got coming up for April. We've got quite a few things to cover before we actually go into the match. So we kicked off March by drawing 1-1 with Burnley at the Valley Parade before travelling to Spain to draw 0-0 with Valencia. We then, I think we're at home for this one, if I can remember correctly. We beat Newcastle 1-0 in the quarterfinals of the FA Cup. And then we beat Valencia to get through the round of 16 of the Europa League back at the Valley Parade with a 2-1 victory. We then got smashed by Arsenal 4-0 at the Emirates before travelling to Old Trafford and only losing 1-0. And honestly, I feel like it should have been a draw, but it's just my own personal opinion. And then we finished off the month with a solid 3-0 victory at the Vitality Stadium over Bournemouth. So the month ended on a good note anyway, and we've got quite a packed month to come up, and it's not going to be the easiest of months. It probably will be one of the hardest. It might result in some very bad Premier League form, but we'll see what happens. We're kicking off the month though against Lazio in the first leg of the quarterfinals of the Europa League before travelling away to Vicarage Road to take on Watford. I think that's our fifth away game in the row, so it's a bit crazy the amount of away games we're playing. We're going to come back home though for the second leg of the quarterfinals to take on Lazio once again before staying at the Valley Parade to take on Everton and Liverpool. And then we're going to be going to Stamford Bridge for the FA Cup semi-finals to take on Chelsea before finishing off against Chelsea again, this time at the Valley Parade. So it's a hectic month. I don't know what results I'm going to get. I don't know what results I should expect. I think I want to try and get through past Lazio, but if I can't, then I can't. I want to beat Watford, at least get a point against Everton. Liverpool, I don't think I'm going to get a result, but I'd like to try. And same with Chelsea, really. I want to try and get some kind of... I want to get some points, really. I want to try and get draws if I can't get wins. I don't want to... I want to try not to lose any, which obviously is the point of career mode at the end of the day. But still, we're going to fix up the squad, and we'll go into the pre-match interview, and then we'll do squad reports, and then we'll be ready to go. I'm going to switch it up a little bit. I don't know if this is going to work out. We're going to give Carbonero... That's not what I wanted to do. I was going to give Carbonero a break, just so if like we needed him to come on, he could come on. My brain isn't working. There we go. My brain's suddenly going into action here. But we're going to do this, and hopefully that'll do the trick. I'm actually going to start Hennessy ahead of Tomori as well. And I did say that I was going to start Dean Henderson for the first leg, so I will do that as well. But anyway, we've got a couple of things to cover still. So I apologise for that. Quite a lot to cover at the start of this episode. Before we go to the squad report, though, we will take the pre-match press conference for this match. And we'll see.
Grazie per essere qui oggi. Possiamo cominciare.
Of course, it's in Italian. Hennessy is in good form. Will we see more of him today? Yeah, I had to put him in the starting lineup, but apparently I'm not allowed to answer that. I have to say something else. I'll just say rotation is key. I'm looking after all players in the squad and the desire to play. Hennessy must make the most of any chances he gets if he wants to submit a starting position, which is why I'm giving him a chance today. Considering Lazio is similar to Bradford City in terms of strength, how do you plan to handle the match in this round? Hopefully, by not losing. We will need luck. We have one of the best teams. We must tread carefully. We've got to tread carefully. We shouldn't underestimate Lazio. In order to go to the next round, we have to be prepared for everything. Lazio went 6-0 in their group. They didn't drop any points. Mr. Johnson, isn't your opinion, is there a chance that Lazio will win the match against your team? If I'm being honest, yes, but I don't think I can answer that. We'll just say there's a possibility. There's a possibility that Lazio can secure a win. Wins never guaranteed, even though we're in good form. We're not in good form, but wins are never guaranteed. If we can get an early goal, I'll be happy. So it means we'll have an away goal. But I don't know how that's going to impact the rest of the game. But before we go in any further, we're going to move on to the squad reports. Bear with me, guys. My headset's all tangled again. Issues all over the place here. Anyway, squad report. Let's see who's grown and who hasn't really grown as much as I would like to grow. Anyway, kicking off in Mars Martensen got up 7 from a 65 to a 72. Carl Fredrickson got up 6 from a 67 to a 73. Lance Hill got up 6 from a 66 to a 72. William Lundberg got up 5 from a 66 to a 71. Vyacheslav Varenkov got up 4 from a 61 to a 65. Valery Anisimov got up 4 from a 72 to a 76. Ethan Robinson going up 4 from a 68 to a 72. Stepan Laganov going up 3 from a 67 to a 70. Thomas Hennessy going up 3 from a 78 to an 81. Donald O'Leary going up 3 from a 72 to a 75. Frederick Eriksen going up 3 from a 63 to a 66. Erling Braut Haaland going up 2 from an 83 to an 85. Mason Greenwood going up 2 from an 82 to an 84. Vyacheslav Lebedev out of load at Ajax got up 2 from a 70 to a 72. Orkun Kutcu got up 2 from a 79 to an 81. Roman Mazapov got up 2 from a 70 to a 72. Johan Carbonero got up 2 from an 80 to an 82. Will Martin got up 2 from a 65 to a 67. Nicholas Cook, I was going to say Nathan Cook for some reason. Nicholas Cook, though, up 2 from a 65 to a 67. Lucas Lindqvist up 2 from a 70 to a 72. Albin Lafont up 2 from an 85 to an 87. Stanislav Grinkov up 1 from a 69 to a 70. Yuri Tielemans up 1 from an 87 to an 88. Declan White up 1 from 60 to a 61. Deo Upamecano up 1 from an 84 to an 85. Fikayo Tomori up 1 from a 79 to an 80. Adam Ljosic up 1 from an 85 to an 86. Diogo Jota up 1 from an 86 to an 87. Dean Henderson up 1 from 81 to an 82. Aaron Wan-Bissaka, Usman Dembele, Landon Wouters and Achraf Hakimi yet to grow. I don't think they will grow. I think maybe Virtus will grow by one, but I think those other three will definitely set the overalls are at because I'm pretty sure they've hit their potential. So we'll see, though. We're going to go into the first leg, however, of this quarterfinal of the Europa League against Lazio, and we're hoping not to get demolished, I think, will probably be the realistic goal. Depending on their team, we might actually be able to do something, I don't know. We'll put the other ones on. Those are the other quarterfinal matches. We've got Everton and Milan, Lille and Monaco, and Hoffenheim and Wolfsburg. If we get through to semi-final somehow, we will end up going against one of those six. So we'll see. But the miracle run in the Europa League might honestly be over right here. I thought it was going to be over against Valencia, if I'm being completely honest, and we scraped past them. We switched up the formation. Hopefully, that means we could switch up the luck that we have and get a win here. But I don't know. We'll see. We've also got it's double upload day, so I'll be playing this one, and then I'll be playing the Watford one. They'll both go up today. Of course, tomorrow's will be the second Lazio leg, so we'll know whether we're through or not, followed by the Everton game in the Premier League. So that's what's coming up this weekend in terms of career mode. In terms of Batman, Enemy Within, I'm sorry I haven't kept up with it. I don't know when I'll do that, to be honest. It depends, because I've been playing a lot of other games with my friends and I'm enjoying them, so at the moment I've not really been playing as much Batman, so I apologise for that. I can't get past these defenders. It's going to be one of these games, isn't it? It's going to be a little game like Man United. Just wanted to finish one off and then go into the game. I know my guy was way offside, but I'll take it. This ought to be a game not just appealing to fans of the respective sides, but anyway, also to neutrals. It could be interesting to see their team. We've got the team for this. It's just, have I got the skill? Here on EA TV. And the stamina with my players, I guess, as well, is a big part of it. Lazio 1900. And we're in the Eternal City at the Stadio Olimpico. I'm Derek Ray here home on the commentary of Lazio. Joined for commentary by Lee Dixon. Only 8 teams left in the race for Europa League glory. We're at the quarterfinal stage. Oh boy, this is big. Lazio, and they take on Bradford City. No other games have been played yet, of course, because we've been playing well at the same time. See the previous results from round 16 there. Just scraping past Valencia 2 on an aggregate. Some other teams looked a bit more convincing in their performances, but we'll see. Lazio better not have any world beaters. Oh, we're fucked. Although they will have a couple of world beaters because they've got this far in the Europa League, so they also might have a couple of players I don't recognise because I feel like there's a couple of players there that are regens that I don't recognise. But we'll see when they show the lineups. There's your boys, the Bantams, along with Theo Johnson, proud coach. They've got Bolly, which, yeah. They've got Lerma, Grich, Kiane. There's a couple I recognise. Klassen, Ocampos, Schick, Belotti. Okay, they've actually got quite a strong squad. They've got some good strikers there. Belotti and Schick are decent up front. We'll see the whole team in a sec. There they are. That's not going to be easy at all, especially when the... What is this? That's an interesting one. They've packed their defence. We can maybe get round them with our wingers. We'll have to see what the strategy we're going to use is, because even I don't know yet. But here is our squad. This is the lineup for the visitors today. I'm hoping Loshik can set through Haaland, or maybe Loshik can score a couple of his own. I'm just hoping maybe we get a goal today and somehow try and shut them out. I don't know. We'll have to see. We'll have to wait and see. And that 110% house is going to go. But Lazio have kicked off, and we're here in Italy to hopefully get 1 foot into the semi-finals of the Europa League. Whether that will occur is a different matter entirely. Loshik. Dembele. They've not got any fullbacks, but they've got Patrick on me right now. I have to play it all the way back to Jota. Back to Dembele. I don't really know what to do here. Play it around to Tielemans, I guess. Loshik. Going to lose out. Well, he's not going to lose out. He's going to keep it, actually. Greenwood slipped and fell. You've got to be kidding me. You don't slip and fall there. Wan-Bissaka needs to get that off Belotti ASAP. Okay, he's passed it back. We're fine. We're good. We can regroup. Jefferson Lerma. Here's Patrick Schick. Well, you can see what we can do. Why we're focusing on this fellow as one to watch. Lee, in particular, what do you expect to see from his game? Well, if Meccano should header, he's not headed it a million miles away, which is kind of a problem. But if Ousmane Dembele has helped the ball away. I don't know what sort of header that was from Meccano. Slightly concerned there, because he's meant to be my best centre-back. Greenwood trying to get the ball back, can't seem to be able to. Belotti just playing around with him. Can I switch my centre back, please? No? Okay, cool. Good save from Henderson. And Hakimi will get it away to Dembele. San Siro has been a goal at San Siro, I should say. I think Milan have just scored past Everton. 1-0 for Milan. Will it be 1-0 to Bradford here? No, Greenwood's not going to make it. Or maybe. Is that a penalty? I was trying to go for a penalty win there. I just didn't know if I'd done enough. Lucas Ocampos has taken Greenwood down in the Lazio area. And holy shit, we might be given a very good chance here to go 1-0 up. We might have just got an incredible chance. Of course, it will be Mason taking the penalty, as he did win it. This is the biggest moment so far, the Europa League. Mason Greenwood to take the penalty. Of course, and they know every time where I'm going to go. If I go left, they dive left. If I go right, they dive right. This is ridiculous. If I'd gone right there, he would have dove right. Oh, I need to learn penalties. I need to actually learn how to put me to the top. Fuck off, honestly. I'm slightly annoyed myself. That's not even the game's fault. Although the goalkeeper does seem to have a knack of knowing where I'm going with it. If we lose, we get knocked out of Europa League. It's my own fault. That should have been a goal. Dead ass, like 100%. Still possible to... it would have been still possible to actually try and get a goal there in that attack if we'd actually passed it to the right player. But of course you don't do that in this club. You just pass it to the wrong player and hope. Here's Patrick Schick. Still on level terms, moving the ball nicely. Keane trying to get round Hakimi here. Could still work for them. Hakimi just watching the entire time like a hawk. Got a tackle, but it's going to be a throw into Lazio. Dembele. Bring it away. Loshik. Tielemans. I want to play it for to Greenwood, but I don't know if he'll make it. I don't know if he's onside. He is onside. And he's just about made up for it. I honestly thought that that goalkeeper was going to save that and they were going to clear it and I was going to scream. But the rebound, and you take what you can get sometimes. The rebound goes in from Mason Greenwood. Made up for the penalty miss. I was really wanting an option in the middle there. I didn't have one. So I had to go for the shot. Luckily, the rebound fell straight back to the captain. And 1-0 now to Bradford in Italy. We've got an away goal. Well, the coach has to be happy with that. This is incredible. We should be 2-0 up realistically, but we've got a goal. Is it going to be a big help in sending us through to the semi-finals of the Europa League. Oh dear. It's not convincing from us, I'll be honest, but we have got the goal. I don't know why Wan-Bissaka doesn't want to chase his man here, but he doesn't. Tielemans has to go back and do it, and he's done a good job of it.
Schick with it.
One of you header it, please. That's, yeah, I mean, it's fucking hell. I didn't realise Dembele and Hakimi were trying to get inside each other to header that at the same time. It's fallen to, I don't know who it has fallen to, number 24. Jefferson Lerma, and Henderson's managed to tip it around for a corner. Lazio now have a corner, a potential chance to equalise here. Ocampos on it. And over comes the close corner, it's headed away, but it's going to go straight back to a Lazio player. I need Wan-Bissaka to get back to his position. Just to play. Grima's going to cover instead, which is fine. Not fully away. I thought Jota would get that. And Jota will get it. Dembele will run. Well, I was thinking of running, but... Can't get the ball to Greenwood. Oh, no, I can. I think that would work. Hold on a minute. Oh, I didn't think the ball would get to Greenwood. We almost ended up trying to get it into Haaland for him to just knock it away with his brain. Obviously not with his brain, but with the thing that's covering his brain. Almost half an hour in. Both teams have had chances. We've got the go-ahead. Go-ahead goal. Can we add a second? Just to give me a bit more confidence. Not yet, anyway. Haaland tried to strike it, but the entire population of the Lazio fan base is there. We won the header with Meccano. And we can build again, but there's going to be so many people from the Lazio team still back. Might not matter. It might matter, actually, because it didn't go. Well, I suppose it did go the right way. I can't even complain about that one. Hakimi. I'm not getting possession there a lot, to be honest. I won it back, though. Yota to Dembele. Pretty sure Tielemans won the initial ball, so I'll give him some credit, too. Not the pass we were looking for. I was wanting a bit... I mean, it was the pass I was looking for. I was wanting a bit more movement from Kloszek, if I'm being honest. A bit faster to get there. I don't want to bring Wan-Bissaka out of position. Oh, fuck. That's a good bit of attacking from Lazio. Another good save from Henderson, though. He's holding it down in the goal right now. It wasn't the best of shots, to be fair. It was right at Henderson, right at his near post, and possibly could have gone wide. But Henderson, not taking any chances. Still 1-0 for the Bantams here in Italy. Ocampos. He's going to get it away. I don't really want them to go straight for another attack when they've got so many bodies up. Sometimes that's the best move. I thought Dembele might have got the ball there, but didn't quite. Greenwood, how has he not intercepted that, though? Excuse me, Greenwood's not got the ball there, but Wan-Bissaka picks up the possession. And he's going to go, and he's not going to stop going until the going is gone. Back post to Dembele, who sent it back to Hloszczyk. It's not quite the goal we were looking for there. I was hoping for a straight header from Dembele. But it almost worked, I would say. Greenwood, I need to turn back with him, but I can't. I've been tackled. Oh, I needed to make some space for myself, do something there, but couldn't. We're going to make the throw anyway. It will be for Bradford City. Wan-Bissaka to take. I need some options. At the moment, Greenwood's looking the best. Even then, it wasn't a great option, but Wan-Bissaka's won it back. Only to pass it to them again, which is not what I was intending to do. Oh, can't get the pass off just to unlock the defence at the moment to get a second. We're 1-0 up, though, so it's not the end of the world.
Tielemans.
I was aiming for the other player that was really close, but that's okay. We'll have yet another throw, and I'm sorry, this is a boring passage of play. I apologise. Try to make something, but I can't seem to do anything to physically get it through. Hakimi, Dembele turns inside, Loshek, Haaland, 2-0 perhaps. What a save. What a good little attack from ourselves, though, if I'm patting myself on the back there for a second. That's a very good save from the Lazio keeper. And Tielemans has won it back in the midfield. Can we get one more attack before the end of the half? There's Man Dembele. He has to turn himself in here. Jota. Don't know if he don't try. His opponent in the nick of time. I don't know where to put that next. Let's take a look at where I could have done it. I could have put it on the edge of the box. That's my fault fully. I was just wanted to try and stab in a second before half time, but we didn't get it. And it's 1-0 to Bradford City at half time in Italy. So not too shabby. But if I'm being honest, I would like a second goal. Just to maybe put it in doubt, like past doubt. They'd have to get two at the Valley Parade. And I mean, that's fully possible. But I'd love to get as many away goals as I can. I'm not 100% on how the away goals rule works, but it's fine. 1-0 to Milan at Goodison Park. 1-0 to Monaco in France. And then 1-1 between the two German teams going at it in the other quarterfinals. So, not a lot of goals being scored in this round. 8 shots for 7 on target for ourselves with 48% possession. We've definitely had the efforts. We just need to convert them into goals. 4 shots for 3 on target for Lazio with 52% possession. Second half, we need to try and consolidate, I think, would be the key aim here. We've got a game against Watford in 3 or 4 days. I don't remember the exact date that it falls on. I think we're gonna have to try and forget about that now and focus on what we've got here. Because they will get better in the second half. They always seem to in the Europa League or in any league. Jota. They pack their defence, remember, so we kind of have to try and break through. And Loshik moving the man to unlock it. Out to Greenwood. I don't know really what to do here, if I'm being honest. Got fouled, but we're going to play advantage. We're going to try and, I don't know, give it to Loshek, turn, shoot. Oh, the other defender was in the way. I didn't want him to turn that wide, to be honest. It's stopped straight by McCann, but obviously can't get it through. The other one's going to be stopped by a... Right. That should have been stopped by Hakimi. I don't know how it's gone past, but Wan-Bissaka's come away from his right back position to tackle, which is good. Well, no Jota to Loshek. Haaland. Out to Dembele. Could we get it across to Loshek? No, defender covers. Not sure that's gonna be accepted, I was hoping I could get it all the way through. Haaland, maybe. That's not Haaland. That's Greenwood. This could be for Haaland. It's going to the wrong players and all the wrong points there. Sometimes I wonder. Yellow card, though, for the Lazio player, David Klaassen. Did clatter Greenwood earlier. Could have maybe gone for the free kick, but I don't know if it would have really done anything for us. Lazio going to make their substitution. Chak Vatadze coming on for Ocampos. It's still very much all to play for here in Italy. We do have the goal, and we have had the better chances to maybe get the second, but that doesn't mean it's over by a long shot. That's not where I aimed it. Bad pass. Hennessy, can you get ahead on that? Lovely, dude. Yeah, no, some of these passes are just not adding up today to where I want them to go. Dembele out on the left. Try and turn in here. And then deliver it. Going past Loshek. Haaland's far post. I just didn't realise, actually, to be honest. It's left-footed and cleared. We're keeping it in their half, or we were. So the pass decided just to absolutely age itself. The problem with Hennessy and not having Tomori there is I think Tomori's a tougher tackler, in my opinion, what I've learned. That's a good ball. And McCann needs to get across. Never mind, the cross was awful. Towards Jota. Dembele making a long bursting run, if I do say so myself. I don't know what I'm meant to do here. Haaland's offside. Loshek, I guess, is targeted instead. Greenwood. Let's see if it helps the opposition. Can't seem to get there. It's going to be cleared. And boy, is it going to be cleared. Chak Vatadze's got a lot of room here. Wan-Bissaka needs to try and make up space here. And because he's tired, I don't know if he's going to be able to do it. Oh, I didn't know what McCann was doing, but luckily Henderson did know what he was doing anyway. And himself with the save. Greenwood's going to get there, you know. I don't know what to do next, though. Loshek Oh my God, I thought we'd snuck it in for a second.
Let's join Alan McInally now, because I believe there's been a goal in the Lille game. Alan, it's a goal for Lille.
This has been so close from start to finish. It's going to be a little foul there. I thought maybe I'd done it cleanly. We're going to make a couple subs. I think we need to, based off stamina. We're going to bring on Johan Carbonero on the right. At least we're going to, that's the only sub we're going to make for now. I'm going to leave it for maybe another 5 minutes, maybe another 10 minutes. See what goes on. See if we can get a second goal perhaps. And then if we do, then I'll be more like ready to, I'll be more ready to decide on what we're going to do. In terms of substitutions, I'm just trying to think my sentence through, but I can't. Henderson gets an easy catch. We're just going to yeet it away because all the Lazio players are forward and I don't want to risk having to. Okay. Okay, I don't know what the keeper's doing. I mean, it's worked. He's not offside. Hennessy would have played him on. But it's going to be headed away. It wasn't the best of crosses. Rushed it because we put him under pressure. Ah, it's a good interception. It's okay, it's come to Hakimi. Bring it away for Jota. Tried to play it through and I couldn't quite. I tried to get over the top through to the player and it didn't work. I don't know why I was saying it's at San Siro when it's at Goodison, but fair enough. Playing safe with it, I don't want to risk conceding this late.
A switch of play now. Crossing possibilities.
That's not the header we wanted there from the Meccano, but luckily that's not the header they wanted from. I believe it was Belotti. I'm just trying. I'm honestly just absolutely goal kicking the fuck out of it just to keep it away. That's when I'm 1-0 up and it's an important game like this, I will do that, regardless of like content. I don't know what they're doing though. All I know is my players are tired and I really need to sub them off, but I don't trust this game to not go 1-1. I may have to just like play a weak inside for Watford, which could work out, but then again it could end up when I was getting smashed by Watford. So
been at their best today, that's for sure, but this game is far from over and the fans are certainly reminding them of that. You've got to think there'll be one more chance or two. Well, pass after pass, maybe
I'm just fully concentrating right now, sorry if I'm not talking. My commentary skills are awful when I try to concentrate. An offside call from my defenders, but it's not to be. We're holding fucking on. I'm bringing on Kutcher. I have to have Polasek have some rest. I'm not going to lie, I did think that was offside. I did tip my foot off the pedal a bit there. No save from Henderson keeps us in it. And honestly, we might be able to just sneak an away win here. I don't know. 5 minutes to go, freshening up a little. I want Hloszczyk to have some kind of fitness. Haaland could maybe have a break if need be for the next game. I don't know. We'll just have to see. We need to think about this game rather than the next game. This game's all that matters right now. It's an easy tackle because I knew exactly what I was going to do.
And space for the cross. And Patrick Schick now.
Oh, it's just off target. I didn't know where they were going to play it, if I'm being completely honest. Jota can play the full, mightn't he? Give him a break. Grifo, it was curving, but luckily it was curving wide into the side netting. That could have so easily gone in, though. We're literally grabbing, or hanging on by a thread to this lead. We've got 2 minutes left, plus whatever injury time here in Italy at the Stadio Olimpico. Haaland can't hold up the ball, unfortunately, in that situation. I'm not sure why. Please. Hakimi with a header. Not convincing at all. In fact, it's probably less convincing than... I think it's something funny, but I'm concentrating, so I can't. It's going to go off the pitch, luckily. Right, we have got 1 minute of stoppage time. I think... I want to say we have this wrapped up, but I will absolutely leather this ball at the pitch in order to just ensure it. And just because I've won 1-0 here, does not mean it's over by a long shot. Look at Henderson taking all the time in the world to take this goal kick. And I am on board with this. If we just leather out the pitch now, there's no way they're going to get it back down in time for an attack. Haaland holds it up. And we are going to head into the second leg back home in Bradford with a 1-0 lead and an away goal to boot. We've held on there pretty good. Lazio did come at us, but we also brought as much to them. A missed penalty will ensure that it isn't 2-0, which is unfortunate because it really should have been. I really should have put that penalty away. It's my own fault for not learning how to put penalties up top. But we get the 1-0 lead. Greenwood dealing score. I'm pretty sure my mum just talked to me, but I couldn't hear, so... Just holding on here in Italy. Right, it should have honestly been 2-0. I'm still mad at myself for not scoring a penalty, but we can't change it now. 10 shots with 8 on target for Lazio. 10 shots with 9 on target for ourselves. 51% possession for Lazio, 49% possession for us. It was more or less even. Maybe it did deserve to be a draw, but Henderson having a hell of a game deserves more than the 7.8 in my opinion. But man of the match goes to Mason Greenwood, the only goal scorer on the pitch. Tielemans, I'm assuming, probably assisted the goal, which is why he's got the 8.5. And in the end, we're going to head into the return leg with a lead. And that's all I could have asked for. There are the other results. Milan beating Everton, Monaco beating Lille, and draws between the German teams. I just realised the other quarterfinal is a French, all-French affair as well. You managed to win your first leg despite playing an away match. Are your favourites to go through now? Not by a long shot. We need to be at our best in the second leg. It's good that we won today, but we still need to be at our best and play the best football we are capable of to go forward. I may have to play a weakened team against Watford. Hennessy's continuous out run of form. How satisfied with your performance today? Must keep momentum. We need Hennessy to keep his good momentum going for as long as possible. He did good today, but being able to keep his form going is what separates the great from the good. We able to secure the victory before half time. Are you pleased with how things went in the second half? Yeah, we kept him out. Should have put the game beyond that, in my opinion. We weren't the better team, so we're just going to go focus on our next match. I don't want to have negativity in the sight. Excuse me. We were full value for the win today. I'm really interested in dissecting today's performance. We're already our sights set on our next match against Watford and our next leg against Lazio. We could celebrate this one, but there's no point because it's a two-legged affair, which means it ain't over, not yet, by a long shot. Landover is giving me something to think about. Boss, I feel I've been progressing and would like to discuss my wages. I feel I should be earning more based on my contribution to the team. Would really appreciate if you'd arrange a meeting with me and my agent so we can go over my contract. We'll get to it soon enough. I have other things on my plate now, but we should get talking about new terms to your contract soon enough. To be honest, he hasn't done a single thing for his team, and I'm going to probably offload him at the end of the season. So, I don't want to keep him unhappy, though, because it might result in my rating going down. But we'll see. Anyway, that's going to... I mean... That will probably end this episode. I'm so glad we got a goal against Lazio. Got an away goal. But at the end of the day, victory. Sorry, my parents are texting me. But I'm going to end the episode here anyway, so that's perfect timing, really. We are not going to be able to get to 7th, I don't think, now. Chelsea are in 7th. There's only 6 games after we played our game in hand. And even then, we're playing against Watford, so we'll still have another game in hand over them. If we win here, I'm pretty sure we can say top 10 is ours. But I'm going to give you guys a poor little reminder, like not a good one, that last time we played Watford, I don't think we did that well. But I think this is when I was still adjusting to Legendary. We did... Wait, what? I don't remember losing by that much. But it's okay because we're in a better position now. But anyway, that's going to end another episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. We got the result, which I scored the penalty. Got the goal, though. Hope you guys have enjoyed, and I'll see you soon when we go to Vicarage Road and try and get our bloody revenge.